said you should never travel for a long time. And I just couldn't do that. Dwight Zonell Thompson, longtime friends of mine, flew over to my home there in Dallas and spent the day with me. And she said, remember my daddy in Bracy Greer, Bell Gardens Church. She said, remember how bold he was and how healthy he was. But he left his blood pressure medicine at home, went to preach at a conference, had a stroke, and couldn't talk for 9 years and sat in a wheelchair. They call a stroke the silent killer. Your health is your responsibility. Healing is God's responsibility, but your health is yours. They talked me out of all my preaching for several months. I canceled 34 conferences. 34 conferences. I never left my home but 5 times in 4 months. Spent my 4 hours a day in God's presence, and one morning he spoke 3 words that made me a millionaire, multi. Decisions decide wealth. I wrote every one he gave me. At the end of the 4 months, I had more money than I ever had in the history of my life in every account, in every bank. I had not received a single offering from a single service, because I never preached anywhere. Just through my decisions. Your decisions have created your income. Your decisions decide your salary. Who you trust, who you please, who you will host on the earth. The difference in seasons is the person you pleasure. The difference in seasons is the person you pleasure. Pleasure is the seed for reward. Pleasure is the seed for reward. Who have you mastered hosting on the earth? I want our pastors to get a hold of this. Train through videos. Don't say the same thing over and over to the same people. Sit in front of a $360 video from Walmart and talk to your people. I made 186 titles of videos training my staff of 85. I have a video on how to answer the phone. Because when someone answers the phone, when my receptionist at the Wisdom Center answers a phone, people don't compare her with me. They compare her with the last voice they talked to on the phone. I called the office one day, and here's the voice I heard. I thought, my Lord, I called the zoo and the real estate company. They don't know how to answer the phone. And it's your voice that decides intimacy. It's your voice that decides believability. Read Proverbs 7 on the harlot. Read Proverbs 31 on the 31, Proverbs 31 woman. It's the voice. Men don't marry beauty. They marry a voice. They marry a feeling. Men marry a feeling a woman creates. Every man succeeds because of a woman. Every man who fails is because of a woman. Every man is trusting a woman. And the woman you trust has decided your whole success. Anyway, your decisions decide. Three words, decisions decide will, made me a multi-millionaire. I didn't win a lottery. I'm not getting business because I give away everything. Two ways to make money, selling or sowing. You choose. The secret of your future is hidden in your daily routine. Something you're doing daily determines what you're becoming permanently. The purpose of discipline is to birth a habit. Your habit takes you toward a dream or away from it. Anyway, aren't these gorgeous? I gave those for you so you can put them around your house. Son, by the way, I hope everybody here that came in late knows my boy is here. Son, would you stand and tell everybody, this is my Jason. age 63 if you could. We ask everybody, if we possibly can, to sow a dollar a day toward children. My reaction to children determines God's reaction to me. I walked in the dump, they call it the children's dump, where thousands of children went through cans in Puerto Vallarta. I walked through there with Pastor Saul Gonzalez many years ago. You couldn't stop the tears. Kids trying to find an apple core, a piece of banana. He said, I've got a staff, but I don't have any money. I said, I've got money, but you, I don't have proximity. You're here. As long as Mike Murdoch lives or Jesus returns, I'll feed every one of these children. We started feeding 1,000 a day. Some of them now have gone up. They've turned the entire place into what they call the School of Champions. Children have graduated, gone into government. Isn't that amazing? A dollar a day, a dollar a day. I brought a book called 1001 Wisdom Keys of Mike Murdoch. And if you feel impressed to sow a dollar a day, you're 2016 for children. If you feel that way, what you make happen for somebody else's children, God will make happen for your children. If you feel that way, where's Brother Gene? Are you over there? Where's Brother Gene, my man? Anybody? But I've got a book called 1001 Wisdom Keys. Son, would you mind helping me over there? Yes, Brother Carlos, would you? I want to give every person who will invest a dollar a day. That's a lot less than Starbucks. And you sow it as God provides for you. If God doesn't give it to you, don't sow it. But a dollar a day is very little to guarantee divine protection of your own children. And I feel like it's something supernatural. Thousands, they're not the only. If you feel impressed to sow a dollar a day through 2016, lift your hand high. They're going to come right to you and give you one of these. Thank you, son, for helping us. Just lift your hand high. Every penny you sow, documents your mercy, your compassion, your caring. It's an easy way to guarantee angelic protection of your own children, in my opinion. Ephesians 6:8, Isaiah 58, if I reach out to the afflicted soul, God will turn on the light in my life. Every pastor here ought to at least set aside a dollar a day for 1,000 children to be fed every single day. Anybody else? We've got several over here. Thank you, son. Thank you for helping me. Thank you. Thank you for that. Thank you. Turn to page 64 and 65. 64 and 65. Let me just check something. I'm on the Word Network. Anybody's ever seen me on the Word Network? Praise God. Hold on one second. Wisdom World Book, ebook reader with over Jesus. Turn to page 66. Wisdom Key 3000, Chevrolet, you're part of the $58 seat. And you probably heard all about the miracles. Page 67, I put that in there because I've been working on my own will, deciding where I will leave my money. And I'll tell you one thing. I want my money to work for me after I go to be with the Lord. And the lady called just a few days ago and put 10% of a will at the Wisdom Center. Doesn't go in my pocket. I don't need it. It's the Wisdom Center. But if you feel led to be a part of that, remember that. Turn to page 69, and before I teach, son, I may have to move that. Just let him move that. You might want to sit. You might sit next to her. Thank you. She's very good looking. But if you're married, don't you look? Of seed sowing where my life has been radically affected. 9 levels. I invested $25,000 in a ministry called Microsoft. You ever heard of Pastor Bill Gates? 15 plus years ago, I gave him $25,000 of my savings. And some weeks ago, in the last 6 months, God's told me to cut off every world system of income streams. I canceled my mutual funds. I closed down every account. And I had my lawyer contact Microsoft to see what my $25,000 had produced for me. After 15 years of investing in Microsoft, they sent me my blessing, $19,000. It's the slowest loss I've ever had. They had my $25,000 for 15 years and sent me $19,000 back, $600. I was having lunch one day with my number one mentor, other than my father, Oral Roberts, my mother. And God said, give him $25,000. And I think God just told him to give me $25,000. We sow up for wealth, we sow down for health. The Bible's full of the explanation. Every seed has a different focus. Every seed produces a different experience. Everything's a seed. My eyes are seeds. My time is a seed for understanding. My words are seeds for feelings. Listening is my seed for knowledge. Knowledge is my seed for changes. Changes are proportionate to my knowledge. I gave $25,000, emptied my savings account. Now, that's 3 times in my life God's told me to give away everything I had. Not my houses, but all my finances. I've cleared out accounts, savings. 3 times God's told me that. Everything I have came from God. My eyesight came from God. My hearing came from God. My family came from God. My health comes from God. I don't have a thing God didn't give me. So I don't get cocky over my tithe. The tithe is his. It's not even mine. And he didn't say the 90% was mine. I argued with Oral Roberts one day for 4 hours on that. I said, but he says the tithe is the Lord's. But he said he didn't say the 90% wasn't. So, you know, I'm trying to. He said, if I tell you this chair belongs to me, did I say the sofa doesn't? Tell somebody next to you, someday you'll be as smart as Oral Roberts. Say, someday you'll be as smart as Oral Roberts. I gave the $25,000 to Oral Roberts in 72 hours, my harvest began. Mike sent me a video singing happy birthday to you. Go outside, Brother Mike. I bought you a gift. It was an $80,000 brand new black Corvette. A few weeks later, a woman drove up with her rare automobile Corvette of Special Collection, said, God told me to give it to you. I'm walking out of a motel hotel room and a preacher calls me. He said, I want to bless you. What can I do for you? You've changed my life. Can you use a Rolex? Can you use a car? I said, no, I don't even like to drive. He said, have you seen the new 545, the BMW? I said, yes. He said, what color would you like if you had one? I said, black on black. And it arrived 14 days later, brand new, $110,000 straight to Germany. Out of that, God's given me Corvettes, Mercedes. I know you're not interested in my blessings, but I want to say this. He called me one day and said, drive around the corner 15 minutes. I drove around there and they were backing off one of those big trucks, a brand new 500 SEL Mercedes. I'm shouting, of course, praise God. And then the phone rings. He said, my goal is to give you a brand new Mercedes every year for the rest of your life. I said, my daddy's 90-something, you know. I'm going to live to 120, so you got a lot of money to come up with. I'm not about to buy a new car. The most I want to ever buy for a car for is $7,000. I'm not going to buy a new car. It's a waste of money. So God has to bless me since I won't bless myself. Wisdom key. God will treat you better than you will treat yourself. God will treat you better than you will treat yourself. I'm not going to spend $60,000 on a car, drive it off the parking lot, have a wreck, now it's used. I can tell you and I are very different kind of people. I was reading the Bible one day. I'm reading the 112th Psalm. This is going to be important because you can write. I thought the other day, in fact, Paula White was talking to me in Lane, England about 8 weeks ago, telling me about Donald Trump's secrets. Donald Trump calls Paula White his pastor. She sits at his own board meetings. He really does have a rare respect for the gospel. She said, Mr. Trump explained to me the difference between a billionaire and a regular person. A regular person reads a contract and signs it. But a billionaire begins with a blank sheet of paper and writes the contract for himself. Introduce to God your own contracts. Proof. A woman in the back of a crowd who had had a hemorrhage of blood for 12 years said, if I could touch the hem of his garment. She was not on God's plan. She was not on Jesus' list. Jesus did not know her name. Jesus had not recognized her, had not seen her. There was no connection. Jesus did not have her on his to-do list. But she had him on her list. And she said, if I can touch the hem of his garment, I know I'll be made whole. She touches it with her own contract. If I can touch it, I'll be healed. Whew. Watching us tonight are people in the Philippines, India, Ireland, UK, England, the Netherlands, Ghana, Canada, Brazil, and the Bahamas. Boy, Roberts was so tired one night when he walked back through the invalid tent where all the invalids lay on stretchers and wheelchairs. He was so tired, he said, folks, the anointing has left my hand. There is no more anointing in my right hand. I'm going home. I got to rest. And a woman grabbed his coat, jerked on it as he walked through, and she reached out and said, "You're going to pray for me." He said, "No, I'm not. I'm too tired. I don't have the anointing on me." She said, "You're going to pray for me. I've come a long way, and you're going to pray for me." And he says, "There's no anointing left, sister. There's nothing left. Come back tomorrow night." And she said, "In the name of Jesus, you pray for me." So he turned around mad and said, "In the name of Jesus, be healed." He said he didn't feel a thing. Nothing. Nothing. Right hand, no anointing. Nothing. He was empty. And she was instantly healed. And he said this. It wasn't my faith involved. She wrote her own contract. Oh, hallelujah. 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 Pastors, get a hold of that. You can write your own contract. God will work with you proportionate to your faith in his word. There's many levels of faith. And you write the contract for your divine experiences with God. So anyway, I'll read the 112th Psalm. And I see it. A man that delights himself and the laws of God, wealth and riches would be in his house. Well, that's just as important as John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever would believe on him. That's just as much as Acts 2 and 4. This is just as much Bible as any scripture. A man who delights himself in the commandments, wealth and riches would be in his house. So I told God I'd give him $112 seed. Above all my faith promise, above all my tithe, I was going to set aside $112 seed and give it an assignment. I learned that from Will Roberts. When I asked Brother Roberts one day, he was driving me through Tulsa. I've spent vacations with him and all those things. I said, "What's the greatest secret of your whole ministry?" He said, "Brother Mike, nobody's ever asked me that." He said, "Sowing a seed for a desired result." He got it from 1 Kings 17 from Elijah, who told the woman to plant a seed for money, for food, through a famine. He taught her, you aim a seed, you give it an assignment, you tell it what you want it to do. Like a woman wrote it on her, "I want my husband saved." He had never gone to church with her 20 years. And 2 weeks later, two Sundays later, she wrote his name on a $58 seed. And he came out, gave his life to Jesus two Sundays later, had never been to church with her one time in 20 years. Your seed has to have an instruction. And every seed you've ever planted that you did not instruct is following behind you, wobbling all over the interstate in your past years. They're talking to each other. One seed said, "What you going to do?" And the seed said, "She's never told me." You got a lot of seeds you planted, but you never gave any of them an instruction. An uninstructed seed has no power. It's impotent. I told God I'd give $112 seed every month. I didn't know what it was for. I just did it as a little covenant I had with God. 112. Well, about the 6.5 weeks later, you know, there was an explosion of wisdom in my life. Just, I couldn't write down. I couldn't record all the things that God was talking to me and showing me about life and things. Just mind-blowing. And so I went to every 7 days, every Sunday. And I made a vow for the rest of my life, as long as Mike Murdoch is alive, I will sow every God's day, every Lord's day, every Sabbath, I will sow $112 seed because I'm in covenant with something he said. Well, shoot. There was an explosion. I went to every day. I'd meet my secretary between meetings, sign 10 or 15 checks for $112 seed. And it was so little, I thought it was kind of ridiculous. You know, that's like Starbucks each morning. Less than $4. $112 seed. Every 7 days that I went to, every single day. One day God spoke to me. Some of you may have been on the phone the night he did. I said, "God just told me he was going to give me a territorial anointing." And I said, folks, I don't remember, I don't really know what a territorial anointing is. I've heard of territorial devils. I've heard of territorial demons. But I don't really know what a territorial anointing is. But we'll see. A couple flies from Manila, Philippines, with a map and a survey. They want to give me land next to land owned by Cathedral of Praise, a great 30,000 member church by Dr. Dave Summerall. They're giving it to me. A man who is the chairman calls my lawyer and says, I want to give Mike 7 pieces of property. God spoke to me. She said, is this for Mike or the Wisdom Centers? Because the Wisdom Center church didn't pay me a penny. I don't get a penny of the tithe, a penny of the offerings, nothing. Somebody said, what's wrong with you? I said, I've worked so long for God. He pays so well, I don't want to quit. I walk off the church in our church platform in Argentina. Man comes to the back with the pastor and said, God told me to give you 9 acres of ground here in Argentina. Woman calls from Georgia. And same thing, you want it for the Wisdom Center? No, I want to give to Mike personally. His personal gift to Wow. I want to give Mike 50 acres. Woman calls from Virginia and said, I want to give Mike 28 acres. The last 2 billionaires roundtable in Bahamas, they asked me to speak. So I flew to Nassau to speak for the billionaire roundtable, something a billionaire conference about. And that was on Monday night, Tuesday night, Wednesday. They meet me in my hotel suite they had for me. And I never charge a penny for anywhere. I've been free my whole life. Been free my whole life. If you sell something, you get 1 price. If you sell it, you get 100. Never sell what you're capable of sowing. They showed me 4 pieces of property they wanted to give me. On the beach, on the road, Bill Gates owns his home. Want to give it to me. I preached there a few weeks ago in October, Monday and Tuesday night. They meet me Wednesday again. They put me in a $15 million mansion. And they said, we want to give you some more land. I got a text while we were here tonight of a lady that wants to give me some land on an island there that has pink sand. Some of you may know about that island. I'm going to give it to me. Raise your right hand high. Say, Dr. Mike, I'm so proud for you. There is no jealousy of me. Thank you. See, everywhere I go, I tell my testimony. And everywhere I go, people do exactly like California people. They stare at me. Raise your right hand high. Say what God does for you. He will do for me. Your faith is no bigger than mine. We have the same God. We have the same God. And I call it my harvest. Ago, I got another home in Arkansas. church members. I didn't know anything about it. She never talked to me about it. She talked to my lawyer about it, and they just sent me a picture like 3 days ago. So here I am sitting here with 10, 12 homes, properties all over the world, two houses, one for sale, will be on sale February the 20th for $2.7 million. The other for $2.4 million is what they've been valued. They're all paid for. I don't like debt. Debt makes me a slave. I don't like to belong to anybody but God. Bless your heart. Your mama must have dropped you on your head. Say, I'm a receiver of the territory of anointing. Say it again, I'm a receiver of the territorial anointing. I woke up one morning. The Holy Spirit said, take care of Ken Allen. My sisters were living in homes that I had either given to them or provided. But Kadonna is a special needs sister. She can't hold a job. We love her with all of her heart. She's the baby in our family. God sit by her home. I called Robert, Deborah, my sister, my number one conversations on the earth. I'll probably leave her more money than anybody. She's publishes every book I write. Every book I write. And I said, sis, tell Robert to come. I do everything cash. The bank is the most dangerous place in the world to leave your money. You ought to know that by now. Someday I ought to tell you my story with seven banks. Seven banks. You want to tell it? I had a $300 check I cashed for a girl from India in our church. She wrote her name on the back. I wrote my name, went to seven banks to cash it. Not one of the banks would cash the $300 check. They said, she's going to be here. I said, no, she doesn't. She's here. She signed. I'm signing. Well, seven banks. Every one of them would not cash my $300 check from the Wisdom Center. I had accounts at every bank. So I said, I want to close my account. We can't do that till we talk to the regional office. Every one of them called the regional office and nobody answered the regional office. Oh, it's a system. If I'm going to trust anybody, I'm going to trust the God that created my freedom. I'm going to trust him. So I got mad. Said, I want to close this account, $500,000. You have another one of my accounts, $250,000. What ministry money is mine? $500,000, give me all my money back. We can't cash it. What do you mean? We can't cash it. So the next day I had my lawyer call the government. They filed an investigation and the bank became very friendly. Because I was investigating the bank why they wouldn't give me my $500,000. I have an account and they won't give me my $500,000. Explain that. I put an investigation on them. They came back and said, here, $500,000 cashier's check. I said, now cash the check. Oh, that would take an armored car at several weeks advance. I said, then give me five cashier's check for $100,000. So they gave me five $100,000 cashier's check. So I took one, the $100,000, said, now cash that one. We don't have the money. I said, I gave it to you. What do you mean you don't have the money? I gave it to you. It's in there. We can't do that. They love paper. They hate cash. Oh, a bank hates to give you any cash. Well, I almost named the bank. I can't risk that. One bank kept $260,000 of my money for 2.5 years, and I couldn't get it because of one word on a check. Bankers think that money's theirs. They couldn't, so I said, break down this $100,000 check to $20,000 cashier's check. So they did. So I take the $20,000 and said, now, cash this one. We don't have that much cash. This is a major chain. Only one out of $20,000 check for me. I woke up one morning, the Holy Spirit said, go to this bank. I wanted anything so bad. It's the Donald Trump syndrome. To say anything that comes in your mind. And the Holy Spirit spoke to me and says, go get your money out of that bank. So I went. I sat there as my staff went up there. I said, leave $5,000 in there in case I have to cash some checks somewhere. They come out with a cashier's check. To me, it wasn't that much. It's a lot to some people. It wasn't to me. And she yelled out. All the tellers had stopped. They all gathered, the management of the bank. Now, I love the Bank of America. Got it in there. Hallelujah. And she holds the money up and said, and the whole customers, everybody froze. Sir, this is a lot of money. What are you going to do with it? Now, I didn't know that right now in the channel that from now on in many parts of America, they're creating a system where anything over $2,000, you have to write an affidavit, a notary of what you're going to use the money for. They've already doing it. They won't let them leave Nigeria now with more than $2,000. The Antichrist system is a money Christ, is a money system. It's a money system. They're going to use terrorism and a brand to okay you. Anyway, how did I get off on that? Oh, you told me to say it, didn't you? You told me to. No, I don't trust banks. As far as I can throw 14 elephants. Put as little in the bank as you have to, just to carry on business. Now, I said all that to say this. The 112 covenant will do something to your head that you never had done. Every morning for the next 30 days, I want you to read the 112th Psalm. It's easy. Just a few verses. And say, I receive it. I receive the covenant. I receive the covenant. I receive the covenant. I receive the covenant. Cosa procoto procoto. I hope I don't have to persuade you that money is a wonderful, wonderful way to bless people. I hope I don't have to persuade you about the grandeur, the majestic power. Money builds churches. Money builds TV stations. Money builds radio programs for God. Money prints Bibles all over the world. But in Christianity, we've been taught against it. One man came up to me and says, when I give to God, I don't expect anything in return. I said, I wrote a song just for you. He smiled, really? I said, this is the song. How dumb thou art. How dumb thou art. Tell someone next to you, he said, he should discuss you in this meeting. Covenant right now. It's page 69. You that are watching us anywhere in the world. into a covenant that you will link them with three financial relationships. Three financial relationships. I command five strings of honor, financial honor in 2016 on the 112th covenant. I ask you within 12 days from tonight, start their first wave of harvest. Make the 112 covenant a testimony for their family, their genealogy, their bloodline. That when 12 months have been completed, every bill shall be paid. The home will be debt-free. They will have a testimony like Mike Burdock. Father, I had never heard of anything like this, but I made my own covenant. I told you if you would give me wisdom, financial wisdom, I would sow the 112 covenant with expectation. You blessed me beyond my wildest dreams. I never asked for a territorial anointing. You told me you were giving it to me. I ask you, Father, in this room, there's several who should plant this seed out of their church or out of their business. There's someone here tonight has a son that hasn't produced. He's going bankrupt. They may enter into a covenant with you for that son and plant that seed in proxy for him every 30 days. Everything you do for me, do for them. And if what I am praying is just for Mike Murdoch's personal gain, may a curse be on me and the rest of my ministry. May my tongue cleave to the roof of my mouth. If what I have said is scriptural, may 2016 the year of unprecedented financial favor, financial wisdom, financial opportunities, and I call in from every direction extraordinary opportunities they never dreamed of. I command the promotions. I command the promotions. I command the promotions in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Glory to God. Oh, just look at, lay your hand there and just as you, and God may lead you differently, but I just feel that this is for every partner in our ministry. I really do. I really do. I don't live because the ministry sells my books. God blessed me beyond my wildest dreams. Sometimes I get scared. When I went to buy my first $1 million home for cash, I was nervous and scared. And I had $1 million cash around me. Why didn't you put it in the bank? Now you know. And I had $1 million cash around me. And I started crying out of thanksgiving. I said, God, why did you do this for me? He said, didn't I tell you I would give seed to a sower? Oh, hallelujah. 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 Just say I'm a receiver. This young man will help you. Would you mind helping him? I want to give two gifts tonight. And to those, one is the Wisdom Bible. I'm sorry, I gave you the wrong gift. I'm sorry. Yes, it is. I want you to give them the Wisdom Bible. Give them just the Wisdom Bible. Every person who's joining the 112 covenant, please lift your hand high. They're going to come with you to you with the Wisdom Bible. I want you to be blessed with this. Do it as God leads you. Do it as God leads you. Look at someone and say, tonight's the poorest you will ever be the rest of your life. Just tell them, tonight's the poorest you will ever be the rest of your life. Oh, hallelujah. Tonight's the poorest you will ever be the rest of your life. Glory to God. Have any promise to brag just like like I do. How many promise to brag and tell everybody what God does for you? How many's ready for the jealous? How many's going to teach your friends to raise your right hand? Oh, if you're a young couple tonight, you're looking for a house, you ought to join the 112 Covenant. Join the 112 Covenant. I ask you to bring your list of your goals and your dreams. And I hope you put, there's an offering envelope somewhere. Somebody have one for me. Thank you. There's an offering envelope. And I want you to fill that offering envelope out right now for a moment before I teach. And fill that out. There's a place where if you're at the very bottom of the envelope, who needs an envelope? Who doesn't have an envelope with the hand high? There's a sister who doesn't. Every monthly partner tonight will get a copy of all that I've taught tonight on CDs. We tape tonight, right, son? So every monthly partner in the ministry will receive everything I taught tonight by CD when we go back home. We'll send that to you. At the very bottom of the envelope, there's a place where you can mark $31 for World Children, $31 if you're joining the dollar a day for children. Those that are joining the 112 Covenant, just put a little check mark there. And if you're needing a miracle home, a debt-free home, how many watched me Wednesday night on Daystar? I taught on the debt-free home. If that's what you want, but write out your strongest desire and harvest from God. Would you write out your strongest desire and harvest from God?
Single day.
this wave to the Lord and say, Father, I enter into a covenant. I enter into a covenant. Say it aloud. I enter into a covenant. Oh, glory to God. I enter into a covenant. Do business through me. Say those words with passion. Do business through me. Do business through me. Do business with me. Do business for me. Do business for me. In the matchless name of Jesus. For your glory. It is done. Say it again, I'm a receiver. Oh, say it aloud, I'm a receiver. Tell somebody close to you, you're going to hear about my miracle. Just like Mike Murdoch brings. Oh, hallelujah. 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 You can keep that with you for a moment. We'll pray over it. I want to tell you two miracles as we're listening to this little song sung. You can cut it down just a little bit. I don't really understand the financial anointing on my life. I just know that the anointing you respect is the anointing that comes on you. I just got a text message while I was between in the break from a pastor in Warren, Nigeria. He's a son of the Lord. He flew to Dallas and asked me in person, him and his wife, to pray for him to have a territorial anointing in Nigeria. He said, I believe the anointing I honor is the anointing that comes on. And within 14 days, four pieces of property have been given to him. Say this, I'm so happy for him. Folks, you got me worried here tonight. He just sent me a note in the break on my phone. And in the note he said, the seed works, Daddy. The seed works, Daddy. His son just received a world-class scholarship to Oral Roberts University. You've got to give your seed an assignment. You've got to focus your seed. The third time that God told me to give away everything I had, I'd saved up hundreds of thousands of dollars because of my songwriting. I'm very well paid. I get a check regularly from Oral Roberts University, from Bill Gaither Music. Jimmy Swaggart sends me a check right on time. Jesus, just the mention of your name. The song I wrote, Mercy rewrote my life. He's a healing Jesus. And I'd stacked up hundreds of thousands of dollars. I never felt so good in my life. I was in my 30s. God said, give away everything. I got to the last 55,000. I got very worried. And he said, every step towards self-sufficiency is a step away from me. I cleared out the account. The next week, I received another royalty check, $8,500. I said, this is God. God's, he saw that I emptied my account. He's already blessing me. Rod Parsley. I don't know. Did you see him on Rod Parsley this last week? Anybody see him on Rod Parsley's program? I was just there a few days ago. I preached hard for 30 years. 30 years. And while I was preaching, he called me to preach for him. I'm just ecstatic. I'm a different man when I have money in my pocket. I don't know if you are. I'm happier. I laugh more. I laugh easy. I forgive easy. Pastor, do you forgive easy when you have money in your pocket? And while I'm preaching that night on Sunday night, the Holy Spirit says, I want you to receive the offering and set it for your ministry receiver for him and Johnny to buy a house. just told me I'm not supposed to receive anything, any honorarium from the church here, no offerings. I pay it my own way, da-da-da-da-da. And the Holy Spirit, people start shouting and praising God. The Holy Spirit said, how would you like to explore and experiment what I could do with your 8,500? I said, that's all right. I'm happy with my 8,500. I'm content. It's enough for me. Clint Brown was my travel assistant. Now, he has a church in Orlando. I said, Clint, go get my $8,500, get my briefcase. Held it up, said, I just had a royalty check for $8,500. I'm sorry. Clears me out. I go back to the, Elaine, you'll appreciate this. I went back to the motel room and plunged into an indescribable sorrow and a depression. What on earth have I done? How many know Rod Parsley? How many's ever heard their music? Ooh. I said, those drums got me emotionally geared, and I gave them. And for 7 days, I could hardly talk. And finally, I said to the Holy Spirit, I gave the 8,500 because I thought that's what you wanted. If I missed your will, I am so sorry. The Lord spoke one sentence. Anything you do in an effort to obey me will not go unrewarded. 6 weeks later, 7:15, on a Tuesday morning, second hour of prayer, I'm walking back and forth, and the Holy Spirit gives me an idea. A second and a third and a fourth. And I wrote them down and I called a businessman, a friend of mine, and I said, Jack, God's given me some ideas for products. These can be sold in secular stores. He said, I like the idea. Give it to me and I'll give you a percentage. As long as it's sold, of every check, every 9 days, you'll get a royalty check. Guess who my first customer was? My first client was Walmart. In every store, I go through Walmarts all over the world, and there's Mike Murdoch's idea. And I got a check every 90 days. Kmart was my second customer. Hallmark was my third customer. You know, jealousy's rough, folks. If you're riding that line, say I'm happy for you, Brother Mike. My first royalty check bought me a gorgeous Rolls Royce, black on blue. In fact, I gave it to a pastor in Nigeria one night. My second royalty check built me a gymnasium. Cash. God's blessed me so much on that 8,500. I could go on and on to the three checks he gave me. And I've never received an offering in my lifetime to buy a jet. God's given me three. Oh, I know what I'm saying. Guys. for free. I don't charge anybody. I think I've had one offering received for me in my travels. I think I've had one in the last 10 years. I said, I do business with God, and God can do business with me. But if you want God to give you a lifetime income like he gave me, you plant an $8,500 just like I did. It wasn't for me, it was for the church there. And first person came up holding his hand high, crying. It's the pastor of the church. $8,500. He's crying. I lay hands on him. He falls flat on his back. God said, tell him, everything I do for you, I'm going to do for him. Tell him I'm going to give him a debt-free jet just like I gave you. Less than 6 months, he owned a debt-free jet, flew me all over Brazil, 19 passengers, Gulfstream, and then had his two pilots to fly me back from Rio de Janeiro. I never get tired of financial miracles for some reason. You're bored, but I'm not. Oh, I'm just thinking of those moments. He had his two pilots fly me all the way back from Rio de Janeiro to Alliance Airport. Meet you there. There, 15 minutes from my house. I said, you can't do that, brother. I can buy a ticket for $3,000. Don't do this. This thing. He said, you taught me two things. You taught me honor, and you taught me the seed. Given to create anything else I've been promised. Mike, how can you be on TV all over the world? 200 nations. Well, let me tell you one way. I was 36, didn't own a chair, didn't own a table to my name, not anything. Had sheets tacked over my windows. A royalty check came in for $5,000. I flew to PTO. Jim Baker looks at the camera and said, I want everybody here to pray about planting a $1,000 seed. I was a $100 man. I never even heard of anybody giving $1,000. And the Holy Spirit spoke to me. I planted my first $1,000 that day. Then the next day, I planted $1,000 for my son, Jason, who I was on a child custody case with. Sunday morning, I planted a third $1,000. That night, a man walks up with a book of rare automobiles and said, Brother Mike, look at this Ford Ventura GT. He said, there's only 19 of them in the world. God told me to give you this Ford Ventura GT. He said, it's serial number one of the 19 available on here. Monday, a man walks in my office and orders and order the best van you could buy. God spoke to me to give it to you. Tuesday, a man meets me at a restaurant, so I couldn't sleep last night. God told me, bless Mike Murdoch's ministry. And he pushes across the table a check I'd never seen like it before, $10,000. The following Sunday night, I'm preaching for preachers in New Orleans, Louisiana, and God tells me to plant the 10,000. God told me to plant 1,000. I planted 3 of them. Then I get 10,000. I'm ecstatic. Don't ever let any liar tell you money don't make you happy. You can do things with money. And I pull out the 10,000 and put it in the offering. From Wednesday through two Sunday nights, I went from a $100 seed sower to a $10,000 seed sower. God gave me a harvest from the 1,000. That's where I broke the back of poverty, 10,000. You forget poverty once you get into that level of faith. What happens? Wednesday, a man calls me. that I met him 30 days before. Hello, Mike. This is Paul, Paul Crouch. Me and Jan were just talking, and God spoke to us to give you some TV time. We want to bless you. We're going to run your program. We'll pay for it. We'll produce it, and we'll run it 4 times a week all over the world. Thursday, Jim Baker called me and said, Mike, this is Jim Baker, and I'm sitting here with Tammy. God spoke to us to give you some prime time. Every Thursday night, we'll give you 9:30 to 10 o'clock on BTL Network. The calculated worth of that seed was $4 million. From the $4 million on television, God gave me over 100,000 partners. Shoot, I'm not going to tell you anymore. I ain't there right now. You don't have to deal with God about your jealousy. You God's going to have to work that out. I'm kidding. I get a royalty check. God tells me there's still 1,000. I've never done anything but 100. I'm shaking, nervous. Now, a lot of preachers say they feel glorious when they give a big offering. I never have. I shake. I'm nervous. God gives me 10,000 cash. That gives a check. I go to New Orleans. God asked me to plant the 10,000. Paul Crouch calls me and gives me free TV for years. Jim Baker gives me free TV for years. People all over the world become my monthly partners. And I'm standing here today with more than I ever dreamed. And it started.
Our God.
there is none like him. He is our God, and there is none like him. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Some, I love this phrase I use sometimes. My God ain't poor. My God ain't poor. Somebody needs to hear that next to you. Just look at him and say, my God ain't poor. My God ain't poor. Would you stand with me? Oh, stretch a little bit. This has been a glorious time with you. Thank you for letting me share what God is doing. How many of this is the first time you've ever seen me in person? Good night. Look a lot younger, don't I? Look a lot younger. 70. 70. I'll be 70 in April. And I'm going to 70 cities across America. God has been good to me. You see, I never heard any teaching like this in my whole life. Never. Never. I was taught if God wants you to have money, how many have ever been taught that if God wants you to have money, he'll give you to you? Yeah. God wants you to take a bath, he'll bathe you.
Brother Gene, the 5001 Wisdom Keys.
every person who's sowing $100 or more tonight, we want them to walk out with their own copy of that. Look at somebody next to you and say, it'll pay you to know me. It'll pay you to know me. Just say it, it'll pay you to know me. Hallelujah. She's waiting here. Did you give her seven songs? Glory to God. Glory to God. You that are watching us online, I don't know if you can see me. Can they see me? Okay. If you'll call the number that's on the screen, I don't know if we have a number on the screen. If you'll call the number on the screen, we'll honor your phone call. And we'll thank you. Thank you for being a part. Glory to God. Thank you. Who's the oldest person here tonight? Anybody older than 86 years old? Anybody else older than 86 years old? Who's the youngest person here tonight? Son, how old are you? How old are you? 14. Anybody younger than 14 here tonight? 14? 11? Oh, son. 11 years old. You're the youngest here tonight. Huh? Give him one of the 5,001 wisdom quotations. Can you bring me one of Truth Out in the Open, Eddie's books? One of Eddie's right there, yes. 86 years old strong. They've been in my life. Thank you, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Drove the furthest here tonight? Let's see. Who drove 50 miles or more? Who drove 50 miles or more? Okay, who drove 100 miles or more? Really? 70 miles? How much mileage? How far is it? Nobody knows either. Less than 200 miles. Wow. Anybody close to 200 miles? Shoot, give her everything. I'm serious. Give her one of the close to my head. Just give her one MP3 player. One MP3 player. Just be there. Yes, that's it. Big one of Daddy's books. Big 5,001 wisdom keys. Yeah, bless her. Jesus. Wow, 4 hours ago. Wow. 200 miles. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. We're going to get the answer. I bet we're going to get the answer. Last 24 months, you started your own new business. Would you stand, read it? Would you stand? Those who started a brand new business in the last, yes, would you stand? In the name of Jesus, I decree an advisory board that circles you near the month of January. And the questions they ask and the input they give you, God will receive that honor for himself. I decree that this next 30 days, you will soak yourself in knowledge. Internet, websites, business cards, business contacts. I set myself in agreement that every person standing right now in 30 days will have a testimony better than you've ever had in your life about your business. God will give you laborers, workers. God will give you wisdom like Abraham, and that everything you touch will be blessed. For the glory of God. For the glory of God. Who is needing special favor with somebody in authority over you? Would you stand? If you need special favor with somebody in authority over you, I'm going to give you the four pillars of job agreement. Number one, this next 7 days, you will go to your boss, the one that's over you, and say, in 2016, you will never have to repeat an instruction to me. In 2016, you will never have to repeat an instruction with me. Number two, you're going to tell your boss, put me wherever you need me most. I'm easy to correct, and I'm very agreeable with people. Think in your mind, you're seeing yourself. You see yourself sitting down, whether it's a woman or a man, you're going to be sitting down in the next 7 days and saying this to them. Place me where you need me.
Amen.
The third thing you will say is, I'm easy to correct. If you correct me, I consider that a personal gift to me. Make me your number one protege. Make me your number one protege. And the fourth is, I will work any hours you need me. I'll work overtime. I'll work Saturdays. Wherever you need me and when you need me, I am flexible. My job is to take away your problems. I'm a problem solver. Oh, hallelujah. 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 Say those words. I'm a world-class problem solver. I'm a world-class problem solver. Secrets. If you knew the testimonies for, I'm telling you right now, something your boss hears creates favor towards you. Something he hears. I called three people today. I'm looking for a driver right now. I'm looking for a chauffeur. I'm looking for somebody to drive me different places who is also skilled in electronics. Who's also skilled in technology or wants to be skilled. Oh, yeah. Okay, I want the happiest people here to stand together. I know I got to drive on down. How far is Anaheim at this time of the night? Follows the law? One doesn't. Okay. Hold your envelope high. Wave it to God again. And say, I'm expecting a 12-day return. On my first wave of harvest. In the matchless name of Jesus. I'm a receiver. I'm a receiver. Glory to God. Glory to God. Praise God. Who can help us here? Brother Gene, we're going to pass here. We're going to pass their offering over to this home. And they're going to put it, he'll put the offerings from here. Would you put the, I love that offering. Yes, they're going to pass it. Pass your envelope to the person next to you. Unless they look like a. This is for me. Thank you. Thank you. Negotiation, that, all those things mixed up. Yes, put it this way if you can. Praise God. Is this for me? Glory to God. That's you? If you have a special word just for me, if you'll write MM and circle it somewhere there, if you'll write MM.